Alice in Wonderland. Once upon a time, there was a sweet little girl named Alice. One fine day, she was sitting under a tree, listening to her sister reading a story. She began to feel bored and sleepy, as she did not like the story. Suddenly, she saw a white rabbit scamper by. It had pink eyes and was wearing a blue coat. Alice was amazed to see that it took out a big watch from its waistcoat pocket. And as it hurried away, it said, "Oh dear, I shall be too late." She thought there was something very different about this rabbit. It could talk, it wore a red waistcoat, and it carried a watch. Alice was burning with curiosity. So she stood up quickly and began to follow the white rabbit as he ran off. The rabbit suddenly popped down a large rabbit hole. Alice jumped into the rabbit hole too. The rabbit went down and down and down and down into the rabbit hole. Falling down and down, Alice said aloud,
"Where am I? How many miles down have I fallen? I must be getting somewhere near the center of the earth."
She wondered,
"Will I slip through the earth to the other side?"
Thump! Alice landed on a heap of sticks and dry leaves. She was not a bit hurt, and she jumped up onto her feet in a moment. She looked around quickly and suddenly saw the white rabbit again. It disappeared, saying,
"Oh, my ears and whiskers! How late it's getting!"
She looked up, but it was all dark above. Before her was a long, low hall, which was lit up by a row of lamps hanging from the roof. There were doors all round the hall, but they were all locked. Suddenly, she saw a little three-legged glass table with a golden key on it. She looked around and saw a low curtain, and behind it was a little door about 15 inches high. She tried the little golden key in the lock, and to her delight, it fitted. Alice opened the door and looked into the loveliest garden she had ever seen. She longed to wander among those beds of bright flowers and cool fountains, but she could not even get her head through the doorway.
"Oh, how I wish I could become smaller!"
she exclaimed loudly. She went back to the glass table, hoping to find a key to a larger door or any other thing that might help her to get out from the hall she was in. This time she found a little bottle on the table. There was a paper label round the neck of the bottle with the words, "Drink me," beautifully printed on it in large letters. Alice tasted it, and finding it very nice, she finished it off very soon. She started shrinking and was now only 10 inches tall and was the right size for going through the little door into that lovely garden. She waited for a few minutes to see if she was going to shrink any further. After a while, finding no further change to her appearance, she headed for the garden. But poor Alice! When she got to the door, she found that she had forgotten the golden key at the table. And when she went back to the table to get it, she found she could not reach it. She could see the key lying there through the glass, and she tried to climb up one of the legs of the table, but it was too slippery. When she got tired of her efforts, Alice sat down and cried. Soon her eyes fell on a little glass box that was lying under the table. She opened it and found a very small cake in it, on which the words "Eat me" were beautifully marked in currants.
"Well, I will eat it," said Alice. "And if it makes me grow larger, I can reach the key. And if it makes me grow smaller, I can creep under the door. So either way, I'll get into the garden, and I don't care what happens."
She took a bite of the cake and started expecting results almost immediately. But nothing really happened, for she remained the same size. So she set to work and very soon finished off the cake. Sure enough, she began to grow and grow till her head hit the ceiling.